Do you wish that you had toys that talk to you and that you could talk back with and have conversations when you're playing with them? What about talking art supplies? Wouldn't that be cool if you had different art supplies that would talk to you as you were drawing? Well, guess what's happened? In the story, The Day the Crayons Quit by Drew DeWalt, the crayons weren't exactly the real crayons that you're used to. So what happens is one day Duncan, the main character, goes to get his crayons thinking he's going to be able to draw some normal pictures like he's always done. But instead, he finds that his crayons have left him notes. Not regular notes, like "Dear Duncan, love purple crayon." No, it's nothing like that. These notes are demanding different requests. These are crayons that feel underappreciated or overworked. There's even a note talking about how some of the crayons aren't even friends anymore. Duncan is so upset. He does not know what to do. He just wants to color like he always has. This goes on in his mind for a long time, trying to find a solution so that he can get back to drawing. He doesn't want his crayons mad at each other. He doesn't want his crayons feeling overworked or underappreciated. So he really has to do a lot of smart thinking to see how he can get his crayons back to normal. If you want to find out if Duncan was successful or not, and if he got his crayons to really go back to be crayons, then you're going to want to check out this picture book called The Day the Crayons Quit by Drew DeWalt.